Hello friends, once again welcome back to my core chemical engineering channel. So today in this video I'll discuss about the numerical problem based on the stability and Rao theory test. So this tutorial is basically the continuation of my previous tutorial. In that I was discussing about the numerical problems only based on the stability and Rao theory test. So let's discuss now. You read the question here. A PD controller having a derivative time tau d is equal to 4 used to control two non-interacting first order systems having time constants tau 1 is equal to 1 and tau 2 is equal to 0.5. The gain of the system is 0.5. Determine the stability of the control system. Assume unity feedback control system. Now first of all, if the question has been given in this form, you have to analyze the question, and then after that what you need to do, you have to draw the closed loop control system as per the question given. So as you can see it here, determine the stability of the system. So first of all, if stability of the system is given, then you can't take the as a positive feedback system, because only negative feedback system is giving the stability. So first of all, a PD controller having the derivative time tau d is equal to 4. So what is the transfer function for the PD controller? I have already told you in my previous tutorials. As you know that it is in the form of tau ds plus 1. It will always be in the form of tau ds plus 1, correct? So you just write it here, kc into 4s plus 1. Kc is the given as the gain of the system, and derivative time given as a tau d. So tau d 4, so 4 into s plus 1, okay. So you just multiply these two, Kc into 4s plus 1. Now after that, non-interacting system. So overall transfer function for the two non-interacting system is basically the multiplication of the individual transfer function. So what would be the transfer function for the first order system is basically is equal to gain divided by tau s plus 1. Depends on the tau value is 1 is having tau 1 is equal to 1, and the other one is having tau 2 is equal to 0.5. So you have to put these two values and multiply. So if you multiply, you will get that 0.5 divided by s plus 1 into 0.5 into s plus 1. Now as the feedback is given as unity, so h is equal to 1. Now h of s is equal to 1. Now if you want to find the stability of the system, first you need to find the open loop transfer function. As I have already told you, so what is your open loop transfer function? Is basically the multiplication of all the transfer function in the entire loop. So we have 1, 2, 3 transfer function. This value is 1. So you have to multiply these two, you will get the open loop transfer function. So for finding the stability of the system, what you need to do is you have to do 1 plus g of s is equal to 0. This is your characteristics equation. Now after getting the characteristics equation in the polynomial form, what you need to do, you have to draw the Routh array. In the Routh array, if you have drawn as per the polynomial degree, after drawing it, you will put the all the values of Routh array elements, and then after that you have to apply the Routh test and the Routh criteria. Like for the finding the stability of the system, Routh has given certain parameters to find the stability of the system. So you can use that, and in the details of the Routh ray test, the theoretical aspects I have already covered, and the link of that I'll give in my description box. You can go click that link and watch that theoretical aspects. Here we'll discuss only numerical aspects. Now you have to put 1 plus g of s equal to 0, you will get this value. Now if you solve it, you will get this final, you will get this equation. Now I have already told you how will you get to know that how many rows will be there in the Routh array. So if the polynomial you get after solving the equation having n degree, nth degree, then the number of rows would be n plus 1. So here the degree we are getting is s square 2. So number of rows would be 3. So what you need to do? R1, R2, R3. Now as you know that how to fill the elements of the Routh array. So here alternate values in the first row, it will start from the first element. So s square having the highest degree. Now the coefficient of this will occupy the first element. Then after that alternate values, it will take alternate values. After that this value will come. Correct. So coefficient of square s square is 1. You put it here. Now after that kc plus 2 here. Now the coefficient of s. Now here now alternate values we need to take. So here the alternate value is s here. The coefficient of s is 3 plus 4 kc. You put it here. After that second element would be after that. So since there is no element, the value would be 0. After that this value would be 0. So R2 is equal to 3 plus kc. Now I have told you how to find a1 and a2 value. For finding the a1 value, what you need to do, you have to multiply these two, correct, minus 1 into 0 divided by 3 plus 4 kc. So if you do that, you will get a1 is equal to kc plus 2. So that's what I have told you, I have gotten. Now how can you say now we have gotten the value a1 is equal to 2 plus kc. So a1 value, this is your 2 plus kc. Now once you get this, now you must be able to tell whether the system is stable or not. As you know that kc value won't go below 0, it must always be positive. So what does Routh array test says for for telling the system is stable or not? According to Routh array, the elements of the first all elements of the first column must be positive. If all the elements of the first column is positive, then the system is your control system is stable. So as we know that here 1 is positive value, 3 plus 4 kc, as we know that kc will be positive even it comes as a 0, then 3 it is positive. Again here 2 plus kc, kc is 0 also, it won't go in negative, value positive 2. So all the elements, now we can say that all the elements of the first column of the Routh array is having positive value. So now we can say that this is stable system. Correct. Now we'll move to the next question. Determine the stability of the control system having the open loop transfer function given as this one. Here open loop transfer function directly has been given. So use Routh criterion, determine the value of gain of the controller for which the system just causes instability. Now we need to find the value of kc at which the system just causes instability. Then how will you find? First of all, forget the things like we are going to find the stability, how we are going to apply the theorems given by the Routh array test. First you need to do that. First of all, you have to draw the Routh array. So 1 plus g of s is equal to 0. G of s is your open loop transfer function that is already given. You put this value here. After putting this value, what you need to do, you solve this equation, we'll get this polynomial equation. Correct. We'll get this polynomial equation. Correct. S cube plus 3s square plus 2s plus kc is equal to 0. Now start filling the elements of the Routh array. Now we know that here is degree 3, so number of rows formed will be n plus 1, 4. So 4 rows, R1, R2, R3, R4. First 2 rows we can fill from the equation only. So here the coefficient of s cube having coefficient 1, you put it 1. Now alternate values you have to go. Now put 2, correct. Now after that, no, 0. So now here also in the rows also you have to put 3 value, alternate values you need to put 3. Then after that the alternate value will come as kc, you put the kc, after that rest all are 0. Now R3, how will you find the R3? You have to multiply these two, 3 into 2 minus 1 into kc divided by 3. So we will get 6 minus kc divided by 3, this value we got. Now if you want to find this value, then what you need to do, you have to multiply these two minus these two divided by, so here 0, here also multiplication 0, so overall value will get 0 only. Now R4, if you want to find, then how will you find? You have to multiply these two minus 3 into 0, so 0 divided by again 6 minus kc by 3, so overall will get kc only. Now we know that for the system to be stable, then all the elements of the first column must be greater than 0. So this is greater than 0, this is greater than 0, kc always be greater than 0, so this is also we can consider 0. Now 6 minus kc divided by 3, this value must be greater than 0. 6 minus kc divided by 3 is equal to 0. So kc is equal to 6. We got the value of kc is equal to 6, correct. So now at once we put value of kc is equal to 6, then this nth row is third row is going getting vanished. Okay, now for finding the value at which it causes the stability, that is kc is equal to 6, and if you want to find that exact value roots which is lying which is gonna lying on the imaginary axis, then we have to do cs square plus d is equal to 0. Now c and d will be the n minus 1th row element, so c would be your 3 and d would be your kc. So we just put it here, c is 3, d is your kc, 3 square plus kc equal to 0, 3 square plus kc, kc is equal to 6 because we just found out it here only. Found out here, if we put kc is equal to 0, then this row, third row would be vanished. Now we got s equal to plus minus 2i. So if you want to plot the graph, then you will get that plus minus 2i. Okay, so this is the value which is lying on the imaginary roots. Okay, so therefore the location of the pair of the root of the characteristics equation lie on the imaginary axis equidistant from the origin, plus 2i and minus 2i, and the value of the gain is 6, for which the system causes becomes just unstable. So basically the question asked here is this one only. Okay, you have to find value of kc, you got the 6 in the gate exam. If the question has been asked like this, then you just put the answer 6 and move on. In case if they have told that you have to find the roots also, then you follow this method. Correct. Now next question, this is very important. I think this question has been asked in the gate exam, so you just read the question. Now given the characteristics equation below, select the number of roots which will be located on the right side of an imaginary axis. So this is the equation already given, characteristics equation. What you need to do, just fill the rows. So first two rows we can fill by from the characteristics equation. So the coefficient of s4 is 1. Now alternate values you have to go. Now minus 1, correct. After that 12. Now for this 5, first element, then minus 17, second element, then 0. After that a1 is equal to, as you know, that these two multiply, minus these two multiply, divided by 5, will get 12 by 5. We have gotten this, correct. Now a2 is equal to, similarly you have to multiply these two divided by 5 again, will get the value a2 equal to 12. Similarly a1 we need to find, a1 is equal to, you have to multiply these two, minus these two divided by a1 again, we got the value minus 42. And b2 is equal to, similarly these two multiply, then this and this you have to multiply, divided by this value, we got the value b2 is equal to 0. Now c1 is equal to, you have to multiply these two, minus these two, so this is 0, so that will be 0 divided by these two divided by again b1, so value will get is 12. Okay, c1. So as you know that here degrees 4, so number of rows found will be 5, correct. 1 2 3 4 5. Now what has been asked in the question is, select the number of roots which will be located on the right side of an imaginary axis, correct. So you see it here, is there any sign changes? Here positive, here positive, here positive, here negative, correct. Minus 42 negative and positive. So number of roots which will be located on the right side of an imaginary axis will depend on the number of sign we are changing, getting changed. So from plus to negative, this is one number sign changes. Now minus to plus, this is two number changes. So what would be the answer? The answer would be 2, correct. This is values how we have calculated. So there is two number of sign changes, so two roots on the right side of the imaginary axis. So we'll get two roots on the right side of the imaginary axis. So guys, that's all for this numerical problems. In the next tutorial, I'll discuss some more 2 to 3 numerical problems. After that, I'll move on to the root locus diagram, how to plot the root locus diagram. So guys, hope it is useful for you guys, and if you do like this video, please don't forget to comment in the comment box. And if you have any doubt also, you can comment in the comment box, I'll clarify it there. And one more request is there, what you need to do, you have to share this video and among your friends, colleagues and juniors, so that maximum people can get benefited from this. So guys, thank you so much.